is 2,310 calories, 3,070 calories, 2,400 calories in it. 300 calories a serving, 4 servings per container. This will put us at 9,500 calories.
This is gonna put us at 10,030 calories.
What is going on, guys? Ethan Clough here. Hope you guys are all having an amazing day so far. I hope you guys enjoyed that last video, that 10,000 calorie challenge, more than I did. There's many times where I thought I was gonna stop it, but I just kept going. We finished it though. Very happy that I did. And as you guys saw from the beginning of this video, we gained 7 pounds from the 10,000 calorie challenge. 7 whole pounds. So that's the goal of this video. We're gonna lose those 7 pounds within the next 2 days. That's what we're going for, that's what we're shooting for. And that is why we are starting off with a workout with the hoodie on, because it's summertime in Florida. It's 85 degrees out right now, 10:30 in the morning. So we need to sweat. And I think honestly, just sweating is gonna help with that. I feel like my weight is high right now. It's due to a lot of bloating, a lot of water weight as well. So I think just these next 2 days, drop my calories a bit, being a caloric deficit, and continuing my workouts as I do with a bit of cardio as well. Since I am training for a 10K, I am running still. So I think with those 2-3 things, I think we'll be able to get back down to our 165 within the next 2 days. But like I said, we are starting off with a workout today. We're doing a pull workout, so I hope you guys enjoy. You never get free, lamb to the slaughter. What you gonna do when there's blood in the water? The price of your greed is your son and your daughter. What you gonna do when there's blood in the water? Look me in my eyes, tell me everything's not fine. All the people ain't happy, and the river has run dry. You thought you could go free, but that system is done for. If you listen real closely, there's a knock at your front door. You'll never get free, lamb to the slaughter. What you gonna do when there's blood in the water? The price of your greed is your son and your daughter. What you gonna do?
Another dollar in your pocket. Now I am the violence, I am the sickness. Won't accept your silence. Beg me for.
Damn, guys, that was a good workout. I don't know if you guys can tell, but I'm absolutely drenched. If you guys are trying to get a good workout in, throw a hoodie on, listen to freaking good music. Like today I was listening to NF, just a whole radio of his songs. Yeah, throw your hoodie on, listen to music that you guys enjoy, that you can focus, and just worry about yourself in the gym. I was in and out with an hour with the jump roping at the end as well. It's been a while since I've jumped rope. Really enjoy it though. I had a lot of fun with it. Honestly, I wanted to keep going longer, but I got stuff to do today, so an hour was all that I wanted to spend in there. Good workout though. Pull workout today. Hypertrophy focused, and yeah, we got it done. Burned about 600 calories according to my watch, so it's a good start to the day. good start at losing that 7 pounds. I'll check in with you guys later. I'm about to have a post-workout meal. It's gonna be my first meal of the day. Probably gonna go with some cereal with milk and protein powder. Probably do about 2 scoops of vanilla whey for my protein with a serving of almond milk, and then probably about 2 servings of Raisin Bran. So it's gonna be probably close, let's see, 380, 200. It's gonna be around 600 calories for our first meal of the day, but we're gonna get our proteins in, we're gonna get a good amount of carbs as well. So it's gonna be a good way to start the day and a good way to end a workout. So I'll check in with you guys later tonight at the end of the night. I got work tonight, so gotta focus on editing yesterday's video, or the 10,000 calorie challenge video. Gotta focus on that, and then check in with you guys later. Alright guys, so the first day is done. Today I had about 2,000 calories to eat, and then got a roughly 10,000 steps in with my exercise that you guys saw earlier. So I'm hoping that by tomorrow my weight is down a bit. I still feel slightly bloated. The bloating has definitely gone down a bit though, but I'm hoping by the time morning comes, all the bloating's gone and we can see what my weight's at there. Alright, so not what I was hoping this morning with my weight. We ate clean yesterday, we ate at a deficit, and we were active, but we still gained a little bit of weight, and that happens sometimes. You can't really control it sometimes, so I'm not too worried about it. I'm just gonna do the same thing today, eat in deficit, and then burn some calories. We have a leg workout this morning, hypertrophy focused. So we're gonna be doing that, and then we'll see where my weight's at tomorrow. But yep, sometimes your weight does go up. Everybody's weight fluctuates, so you could be eating in a deficit, you could be extremely active but still have a high day where your weight does go up a bit, and that does happen, and it's nothing you can really control. You just gotta stay positive, have a positive mindset, and just keep moving forward, keep going, and keep doing what you're doing, and then you're gonna see the results. So we're gonna do that today. We're gonna keep at it, try to drop down a little bit of weight. Obviously probably not gonna get back down to the 165 point whatever, but I do want to get back down a little bit of weight and see where we're at in the morning. So we're gonna hit this leg workout now. Show you guys a few clips from it. Hope you guys do enjoy. Guys, I feel like absolute shit right now. Like, don't get me wrong, I had a good workout and everything, but I'm just feeling so bloated. Like, my stomach hurts so bad. Yeah, that's where I'm at right now. Good workout though. I mean, I hit a PR for squats. I did 4 sets of 10 at 225 pounds, which is a PR for me, I believe. I think I've done 225 for 10 before, but not for four sets consecutively. Overall, good workout though. Got great leg contractions, especially with the Romanian deadlifts. Those things are amazing. If you guys are not incorporating those, you must. Like, probably the best movement you can have for your hamstrings. Quad focus squats put your heels on a little bit of an incline, put them close together in like a V shape. Those are great as well. I use the Smith machine because it's a little bit easier to do. But yeah, those are great as well. Great for focusing on your quads. For my program, I have like week A and week B. So it's a 2-week program and I've been switching it on and off every week. But week A has movements more focused on quads, where week B has more movements, isolation movements that is, focused on hamstrings. So like next week, I'll be starting week B, and that will have, instead of like quad focused squats, I'll be doing sumo goblet squats, so that will be more focused on the glutes and hamstrings. But yeah, overall good workout. Feel like shit though. I'm gonna push back running. I think I'm gonna wait till tonight, see if I feel a little bit better. But we're going to Topgolf. If you guys don't know what that is, it's this driving range. It's super nice, super cool. We're going for my grandpa's birthday. So we got that today. And then after that, I have work. So then I'll run after work at night when it's a little bit cooler and maybe my stomach will be a little more settled down by then. So 8:30 now. I'll probably talk to you guys later tonight when I'm getting ready to go on my run. Alright guys, so it is about 11 p.m. now and I just showered and weighed myself actually, and my weight now after just weighing myself is actually lower than it was this morning, so I'm very excited about that. I never got to the gym tonight to run just because after work, after golf and everything like that, I was super tired, so I'm not doing that. But I'm excited to weigh myself in the morning, see where I'm at. Like I said, my weight now after a full day of eating and drinking and everything like that is actually lower than it was this morning, so I'm super excited to weigh myself in the morning. I think that we could possibly be under 170 in the morning, just based on what I'm weighing right now, so I guess we'll find out in the morning. I'll see you guys then. So that is what I am talking about. The next morning, and my weight was down to 169.6. It is 7 a.m. right now, so I have a feeling that if I did sleep a little bit later, say maybe 9 o'clock, and then I weighed myself, my weight would be even a little bit lower than that, just because of the fact that your body has more time to break things down and stuff like that, have less water weight. I am super excited about that. I am feeling way less bloated this morning than I have these past few days. So that is good, because that was honestly, that was horrible. That was the worst part about it, I think, was just the feeling of feeling so bloated and kind of slow. And I didn't change anything with these past 2 days. So like the day before, I ate about 2,000 calories and it was pretty active. And then I ended up gaining weight. And then last night I ate like 1,900. And change, and still was basically had the same activity levels as the day before. So I didn't change anything, but look, we lost weight. So sometimes if you guys do have a bad day where you do like gain weight or your weight doesn't go down even though you had a good day of eating and stuff like that, just give it time. Sometimes it does happen. Sometimes you guys do have a bad weigh-in, bad day. It happens, don't worry about it. Just keep doing the same thing you guys were doing. I can assure you that it will change. Your weight will start to drop. So this video wasn't a complete failure. However, I did not get back to my starting weight, but I'm sure within the next few days, my weight will be back to normal and I'll update you guys on that. But I hope you guys did enjoy this video of me trying to reverse the 10,000 calorie challenge. 10,000 calorie challenge sucked. I'm glad I did it though. It was a new experience. Training wise though, if you guys have no reason to do the 10,000 calorie challenge, Like, I'm doing it for you guys so you guys can see it, and I wanted to try it out. But if you guys have no reason to do it, I do not suggest it, just because of the fact that the next few days you're not gonna feel good, and then your weight's gonna be a lot higher. So if you are bulking, like for me now, I'm gonna have to spend a few more days trying to get back to where I wanted to be, like that 165-ish. Whereas I could be spending those days during my lean bulk trying to gain weight, trying to get stronger, but now I'm just dropping weight again. But after this, I don't think there's gonna be too many food challenges within this summer. Maybe in the fall, maybe not. We will see. But for now, probably gonna just have that challenge and then wait till the future to do more. But that is gonna be all for today's video. Hope you guys did enjoy. If you did, alright guys, like I said before the camera shut off, because my storage is full, I'm going to end the video here. If you guys didn't already, please do drop this a like. It does help the channel grow. If you guys are new here and you did enjoy this type of video, make sure to hit that subscribe button as well. Comment down below, share this video, just help spread the word. But other than that, I hope you guys did enjoy. I hope you guys have a great rest of your day. I appreciate you guys. If you did stay this long, have a good one, and remember to never settle. When I started up